Good morning, my friends. Today it's early in the morning. I just woke up and getting ready to score this thing. Advanced Acoustic MAA 406, and that's the power amp, and the preamp is the MPP 206. And well, it is 10:38, and I go. My brother-in-law scoring this set, but I'm doubting this set, my friends, because the thing is, I made this new audio table, and I placed this beautiful but beautiful Onkyo on top, and now also placed a tuner between it, the Onkyo tuner, because we discovered that internet radio is not the same quality as so streaming internet radio is not the same quality as a real tuner. I have a video from that already. It will come soon online. And so I want this thing as my main set. I mean, watch this beautiful, beautiful Onkyo M504, and from a few people, and especially Marcus from Germany, told me that this set, the M504 and the P304, the preamp, the weak link in this set is the preamplifier. He told me that this amplifier is the M504, is a hell of an amplifier. I think I like this sound. I think I like this sound. But I have it now for 4 weeks, non-stop spinning. Hope that I can like the sound, but I don't like the sound, my friends. And that is because of the preamp. I will make this video, so this 504, this Onkyo on the power amp, I will test it. I will make videos from that with, for example, an Amkron preamp. That's a very good amp, Amkron, the SL1, very good amplifier or a preamplifier. I can learn from either a very good amplifier, preamplifier. I will place that Sansui AU X911DG as a preamp to see how it reacts. But this preamp, and that's the problem, my friends, I do not like different things. I like sets. I like sets. I do not like this amp driven by another amp. It doesn't matter, even if the sound is much better, I do not like that. I prefer a integrated amp or a set, integrated amp or a set, but not a power amp with a different kind, a different brand kind of preamp. This is me. This is me, and I know this is stupid because that will be, in the end, there will be only one choice, and that is a integrated. And an integrated is, in fact, also, my wish, my big wish is a Acuphase A406. That's my big wish, but they are still too expensive. They are around, well, you have to be lucky to find one for 2200 euro. You have to be lucky. So they are too, there's not an option at the moment. I think they are too expensive. Yes, so not an option. Not now, not now. But maybe tomorrow I change my mind. I say I'm going to score one, you know. But for now, I think that's too much money. Okay, so that is my end goal, and that's an integrated. But then you have a fantastic sound, a fantastic looks. It is complete. I have now a few options. So this Onkyo, and you know, it is a beautiful thing, and the power amp is a very good one. Only the weak link is the preamp. Another preamp. I will test them out. I will test them out. I will make videos for it, but it's not an option for myself. You know, I'm only curious how this amp sounds with different preamps. And another option is my old Akai AM93. That's another option. Go back to that Akai. That is a fantastic sound, integrated. Enough power, 2 times 120 watt, 2 times 130 watt. Another option is that Sansui AU X911 DG with inbuilt DAC, very good DAC. Another option is the Accuphase E202. I don't like the looks. I'm gonna sell the thing. Another option is the Bryston 4BST. That one is a monster. Very good sound, my friends. Very good sound. But I just make this table. The table is 45 centimeters wide, 45 and a half. So from the 100 amplifiers, 97 will fit on it. But this Bryston is 47 centimeters wide, so it will stick out. Not an option. Not an option. And I have to have a. Well, if you buy that matching Bryston preamp, it will be too expensive. Then better I buy a Accuphase. You understand? So these are my options. So in sound wise, I have well maybe one of my old Marantzes, those vintage Marantzes. Maybe I have to try one of them. Maybe that will do. And I have the looks. I haven't integrated. I only don't have so much power, but maybe because I can't play hard or loud here in my apartment. So maybe that's one of my options too. But sound wise, I have the Akai AM93, the Sansui AU X911 DG, the Bryston power amp, or this thing, the Onkyo, what you see now. So, or the Accuphase E202, that's another option. And probably I have some more. No, I don't have amplifiers upstairs or receivers what are powerful enough for these speakers. So I'm looking for power. I have plenty nice things, but you know, a 2265 is only 65 watt. My Akai over there is only 2 times 75 watt. The Akai AA1175. So if you want something from 100 watt or above with quality, I have only these options left. So I thought, and this is a beautiful thing, my friends. If you see this in your living room, that's why I love this Onkyo so much. It is beautiful, but the sound. Even after 1 month, 1 month non-stop spinning, I can't fall in love. I don't feel nothing for this sound. It is like, you understand? I thought, okay, the looks, you know, the looks can turn me on. But if you love a woman, and then you say love makes blind, that's true. That's true, my friends. Love makes blind. I experienced that many times in the past, and love makes blind, and you do not see the weak points of that woman. You understand? If you are in love, and I thought, okay, I am in love on this Onkyo, but it is not the same as with a woman, because you know, woman is something else. You are in love, and she have their weak. Maybe she's a terrible woman, but you are in love, you know. You don't see the terrible things. But in stereo, it's just something else. It is a beautiful thing. I am in love, but not for the sound. That's the thing. So, what did I do? And there it is again. There it is again. Did you remember my scorings video? Let me go to my page. Let me go to my page. That's scorings video. Where is it? Where is it? Let me see where it is. I have the scorings video somewhere here. Because I, hey, where are those? Yes, remember this video? Well, okay. This is the video from where I scored the Heiko the statement. And let me open the thing. And as you can see over here, this guy had a integrated. I looked it up and integrated with 2 × 90 watt. And this is a CD player. And connected to that integrated, also from Advanced Acoustic, he has 2 mono blocks. Probably the 2 × 90 watt was not enough to drive the speakers. So he bought later those 2 mono blocks. After I bought the speakers, he told me he's going to sell this stuff. So only, not the CD player, but this thing what he used as, he used it now as a, well, as a pre-amplifier for those 2 mono blocks. And it is a beautiful thing. What's this? What's it? The VU meters aren't working because it is used as a preamp. Anyway, this thing I saw for the first time and it sounded okay over these 2 mono blocks. But the thing is, if you see this thing, then you think, wow, this is beautiful. 2 × 150 watt. 2 × 150 watt, and the pre-amplifier have a very, 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 very special. It have a sub out. It have a sub out. Let me see. This is the phono. It should have a sub out. Well, I think it is over here. The sub out. Yes, but it have a sub out, and that is special. For a thing like this, but anyway, the thing is, I almost am convinced for 99% this thing will not sound better as the Onkyo. I almost convinced, so I have to drive. I start 12 o'clock. No. Half past 12, I have to go to my brother-in-law because he's going with me. He's going to film me. And it's now 10 to 11. So I have just 30 minutes left to make a decision on what to do. It is an hour driving. And I made another video. It will come online soon. And that is because many people read the wrong reviews. They see the wrong reviews. And that video, my friends, is very important. You have to watch that video. I explain you things, how to see if something is good or not good. Yeah. And well, this part also comes in my video. Not this part in that video, but this is how I watch for tests. And as you can see over here, the predecessor from this amplifier was the MMA405, and it was tested as very good. These guys, I don't trust them anymore. In the past I trust them, but I don't trust them anymore because he gave it sehr gut Spitzenklasse, 85 points. Okay, and I think so. How can the newer model be only 41 points stereo? So, and this one I trust one, this reviewer I trust 100%. That's why you have to watch my next video about which reviewers you can test. I explain you everything in that video. And this guy only gave it 41 points, 41%. And that's not much at all. You can see that's not even half, not even 50%. So while the MMA 405 is tested as very good, one, the best what you can, so one point is the best you can get. So how can a one reviewer test a thing as the best you can have, and stereo test the thing as 41%. You understand? Also, I saw a ad like this before from this from the same amplifier, and the guy in the ad he wrote that he did a complete recap with very expensive high-end Japanese caps. So I think, why would you do a recap if the thing is from 2008, 2009? Why would you do a recap? Probably the guy thought, okay, the sound, I'm not happy with the sound. I try some quality caps. But those quality caps didn't change the sound. And that's why he, after 1 year after the recap, he was selling it again. So I you don't have to ask somebody, why do you do a recap after 10 years? Because the thing can't be broken, impossible. Why do you do a recap after 10 years? So probably the looks are fantastic from this thing. The looks are just fantastic. You agree with me? They're just fantastic. It is Advanced Acoustic. It is a French brand, but they made everything in China. And not sure, you know, I read different reviews. Some of those reviews say fantastic. But I trust in stereo. That's why you have to watch that coming video, how to test, which reviewers are trustworthy, yes? So because stereo, give it a 4.1, I'm 100% convinced that it will not sound better as that Onkyo. But it is second hand, so if I buy it, I can lose 50 euro, not more as 50 euro. Not more. I cannot lose 100 euro on the thing. Maybe I play even. Maybe I even if I resell it, I make some money again. So, but it is 1 hour's driving, and it is a lot of money, my friends. It is not cheap. So, but the price is so good that I cannot lose more than 50, 75 euro. You know, so it maybe even play even, or maybe even gain something if I resell it. So. It's not a gamble, you understand what I mean? Not a big gamble. But the thing is, maybe, you only know if you have the thing yourself. So I think, well, maybe the looks are fantastic. Maybe this thing can sound good. You know, you understand what I mean? But the thing is, if you see... How do you recognize if something is good or not? Well, if something comes online very often, it's not that old, and you see it comes online very often, people wants to sell something, then probably they are selling because of the not so good sound or the bad sound or the... Do you understand? That's the reason people sell these things or resell it after they bought it. And so... I see that I see many people, not many, but I saw it a few times that even this is a 2008 device that I saw persons selling Advanced Acoustic stuff 3-4 years old. They place it on the market, and that's too short. So that's there have to be a reason why they are, because it is beautiful stuff. Why you want to sell that beautiful stuff? Because of this bit of the bad sound. If the sound was good, you would not see these young devices coming on the second-hand market so quickly. You understand? So, and there are some reviewers who say, yeah, it's fantastic, it sounds very good for the price, without really telling or saying you what the sound really is if you compare it with, for example, a Acuphase. Okay, there's not much to compare with an Acuphase, it's true. But for example, my Akai AM93, that thing comes close to an Acuphase. That thing is just a fantastic sound, you know. And I still have it here, thinking of selling the Akai AM93. But Is that smart to sell the thing, you know, because how much you can get for it? 450, 500 euro? Not sure. Okay, I have that Accuphase or that Sanssouci. That's an option, but that is not a beautiful thing. That Bryston is not a beautiful thing, you know. And, you know, I made this table. I made this table. And to have something nice in my living room, I'm going to change all those speaker wires and thick cables, so all that mess will be gone. I bought a new television above it, so I did some interior design changes in my living room, and I'm very happy with the table how it is. This is a beautiful table, my friends. But do I want a Bryson on top of it? What is sticking out? Do I want a Sanssouci AU 911 DG, what is just like my old Aktai AM93, a boring thing, you know, if you compare it with this Onkyo. So, but yeah, I don't want a this Onkyo with another amplifier, pre-amplifier. I'm not audiophile enough to do that. You know, then you have maybe probably a very good sound, but then you have a strange, not fitting pre-amplifier, you know, and so that's why I was interested in buying this. I'm going to buy this. I'm going to buy this. Check it out. But I already know almost for 90% sure because of this review, testberichte.de. There are so many reviewers, so many, but only two I trust, and one of them is Stereo. And Stereo give it only 41%. Yeah. So this is not correct. It's not a Spitzenklasse. The MA. So his predecessor. So the older type, the older one. How can this be very good? One point is the highest you can have. And in comparison with if Stereo say no, it is only 41%. So that means that, no, these guys are just reviewers, just guys who bought it and give their opinion, but they don't, often they do not know nothing about sound, you know, they think they have a good sound. So, because Stereo tested 40, I'm now doubting if I have to drive, but yeah, my friends, it is a beautiful set. It is a beautiful set. And the pre-amplifier have a sub out, and that is strange. I miss a balance knob on this pre-amplifier, very strange. No bass, no treble, nothing. Only a volume knob, no balance. And well, these are all selectors. You know, this, I'm not sure how it just works on clicking on these knobs. Anyway, this is it, my friends. This is it. So I'm going to drive. And but I already know this cannot beat. Of course, I hope it sounds better as the Onkyo. It comes very close to my Sanssouci and my Akai. I so hope. But anyway, I'm not feeling normally. I'm feeling happy when I'm going to score something, but in a way, I do not feel that happy. But yeah, you know, if I do not buy it, if I do not gonna score it, I will never know. And maybe in 2 years I see it again, and again I have these doubts. You know, try it or not try it out. So that's why I'm going to score it once and for all. Know what this sound is, and I have to experience this myself. It's not for you, my friends, for myself. This is for myself. So sometimes I score things for you know, to review, but this is pure for myself, you know, because I, yeah, the Onkyo, after 1 month listening, I have enough from the thing. And to be honest, it is beautiful, but yeah, and maybe I keep the Onkyo, not sure. So I'm going to drive, and I hope I can film there. I hope so. He have some special speakers, this guy, because he have this. Let me see. these speakers, Etude Clio. He told me these are very good speakers. So I'm very curious how this speaker sounds over this amplifier. This is made in Belgium. He was telling me a story, a very long story about these speakers. I did not understand him, but he told me they are special speakers. So, not sure. Not sure. Never heard of the brand Etude. Anyway, this is another ad from him. He's selling his stuff. And okay. And of course I will take my phone. I will take my phone and I will hook up my phone to see, and I make of course a video with you will see that video later, okay? Well, I have 30 minutes left to shower, and then I will pick up my brother-in-law and to score this thing because, well, yeah, why not? You know, I have to try it. I have to try it out, and probably you are also very curious how this thing sounds. And but the signs, my friend, this thing, and what I earlier discovered from this brand that, no, the sound-wise, it is not, you know, if stereo give it only 41%, yeah, no, I'm gonna call my brother-in-law to see what he is thinking. I'm going to explain him my doubts, okay? Well, guys, as you can see, we are en route. And we are in Ede. Ede, that is about, yeah, 94 kilometers from my house. And well, this is it, my friends. My brother-in-law is driving. This is it. A
little bit quiet.
This is it. Sure, 4 minutes, 2.7 kilometers. But navigation say we have to go straight. We have to go straight. And so this is it, my friends. Here we are. I see a lot of bicycles. A lot of bicycles today. And we are middle in the corona time, my friends. So the guy asked me yesterday if I'm sure I don't have a disease because he have little children. So me and my brother-in-law, we just discussed how can we get the price lower. Well, I start coughing and he starts sneezing. At the moment we say, yeah, it's a little bit too expensive. No, this was a joke. It's a joke, my friends. A joke. This is a joke. Yeah, my friends. It's no joke. It's Corona time. It's no joke. It's a bad thing. And I hope normally you will see much more people outside. But yeah, in this period, my friends, it's better to stay home. So, no joke. No joke, this disease. I mean, some people think it's nothing. But yeah. And you take a risk, a gamble. Beautiful,
Over
beautiful.
500 meter, neem op de rotonde de eerste afslag naar de nieuwe kazernelaan.
Okay, we are almost there. According to my navigation, 1.4 kilometers. Yeah. First one to the right. Wow. Come on, come on. These people are not in a hurry, I can see that. We have here the pannenkoekenhuis.
Over 600 meter sla linksaf naar de nieuwe Klinkenberg.
Well. This looks promising, hè? Eh? This looks very promising, but I'm not sure where we are. Okay. We have to go, I think, here.
Sla linksaf naar de nieuwe Klinkenberg.
Yeah. I think. Well, guys, this is it. And to be honest, I did a little test over, what is the name of the speakers?
Etude.
I showed you in the ad, he had two, the other one, the white Etudes, are smaller. These are the bigger Etudes. He's not going to sell them. What is the story of Etude? You told me a story about Etude.
It's a Belgium builder.
Yeah.
Doesn't make them anymore. Moerbeke, it is called. And, it's magnificent, I think.
And why did you thought these speakers were so good, I'm going to buy them? What is the reason? I always want to know why people are interested in a certain speaker, an unknown speaker. I never heard of the brand.
Yeah, I just heard them for a family of mine has them, and I heard them there. They were amazing.
So you heard them with a family member, but you never audienced a audio shop to listen more speakers.
Also, okay.
Because if that was your only reference point, my friends, then I said didn't do it right. Always go, never buy online. Unless, of course, you heard them somewhere else and you know you want those speakers and you can find them online cheaper, you're smart. But never buy online because you saw a few reviews. You know, soon I will upload that video where you can, which reviewers you can trust. Because I saw different reviews from this set and Stereo gave them, no, Audio gave the predecessor from this, the MMA 504, 95 points, Spitzenklasse. And this one was reviewed by Stereo, only 41 points, so 41%. So that's the reviewer and the reviewer, you know. And you will see that in my next video, and you have to see this video, very important if you, you know, if you, how you can recognize the good reviewer. Anyway, this is it, my friend. I mean, yeah, the money I pay isn't that much, but what can you buy for that money? I mean, if you go to the shop nowadays for the price I'm gonna pay, and I didn't pay any yet, not yet, but what I'm going to pay, I mean, you take up close, what's those? It is just beautiful, and I only hope that it sounds a little bit better than my Onkyo. I don't believe it, but yeah, that Onkyo was a 2500 guilders, so about 1100 euro new in 1986. That's what I have now, but that was in 1986. We have the inflation, so it is about 2 times 165 watt. This thing is 2 times 150 watt. So nothing to complain about power, nothing to complain about the looks. The looks is fantastic. This thing has a sub out, so maybe I can finally connect that 15 inch subwoofer from Clips. Maybe I bought the thing for the show, for my table, to make my table. But yeah, maybe to test it out, you know. I hope this thing sounds better. I hope. And I will. What is this? La Audio? Where this thing comes from?
This is a European brand or Chinese? Chinese. Okay. How much did you pay for this thing? This is a I'm not sure. Like Laudio, he's happy with tubes like Ivor, tube guy. Okay. Anyway, I'm just one test. Just one sound. One sound. This is how it sounds. Yeah, this play. The guy is in a hurry. I'm going to pay him. And well, thanks for watching. Wait for the review when I'm home. You know, I hope I test it on my. I cannot say how the sound is because I don't know these speakers. You know, so I know exactly how this thing sounds when I tested it over my or my Heikos or my Cantons. Yes. Well, thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up. For now, I say ciao ciao.